Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. It is a 2 a.m. upload, so I apologize if I don't have that much energy right now. Also, I need to be a little bit quiet, so I apologize for my low voice. But today I wanted to go over the new Battle Pass for Season 6, because there are some things this time around that we've just never seen before, including new copyrighted music that you could play while driving a vehicle in Warzone and or Ground War. We also got some more Black Ops themed music, which I thought was kind of crazy, and the pass itself has a lot of Halloween themed items, including this awesome looking AS Val variant that you'll unlock at Tier 100, and that comes with some Dark Tracer rounds. So let's go ahead and take a look at the entire pass. Once again, I just want to mention, if you plan on picking up the Battle Pass for Season 6, make sure to use my code PRESTIGE in all caps. It's free to do. It goes directly to supporting my family. I truly, truly appreciate each and every one of you that have already used my code. You can also use my code on shop items like Undead Forces. This pack just released, and it includes that undead hellhound that can execute your enemies for you. I really like this pack because not only does it give you the hellhound, but it has a ton of references to classic zombies from the Treyarch series, including a skin for Sid that makes her look like Primus Nicolai. So really, when we were talking about that a couple of days ago, we weren't wrong. It actually is Nicolai, but it's a skin for Sid. Not a character I thought would be getting it, but here we are. Now, right off the bat, in tier 1 through 20, you're going to notice a lot of really awesome items, including a throwback to Farah's unfortunate run-in with an enemy at their own house. Of course, you needed to use the screwdriver to take out this enemy while she was a child in the campaign. The screwdriver makes a return, as well as this outfit for Minotaur. So if you wanted to be the bad guy, you can use the outfit that was in that specific campaign mission. You could also use the screwdriver. And since there's Damascus camo, technically you can go ahead and stab this guy once again, but with Damascus, to let him know that you really improved over the years. The other thing that you'll notice right away is we have a new War Tracks pack. Something Infinity Ward did a little bit differently this time around was they added a classic Black Ops pack and a classic Modern Warfare pack, providing War Tracks from MW1, 2, and 3. We also got tracks from BO1, 2, 3, and 4. Honestly, it just feels kind of weird listening to these tracks once again. I know that the nostalgia is very high for them, so adding it into this game is really, really cool, especially since it's going to be used in both regular Modern Warfare and Black Ops Cold War moving forward in the future. All of these customization items are available in both games when it comes to the Warzone experience. Now, on top of that, we even got War Track packs that include copyrighted hip-hop and EDM music. Now, unfortunately, I definitely cannot play this music for you guys because I'll get a huge copyright strike, but some of the music that you'll find in the hip-hop pack is What's Poppin', Rough Riders Anthem, and Grindin'. And then the EDM pack is going to include Bangarang, Scary Monsters and Nice Sprites, and Party Time. All of these are just some crazy throwbacks, and the fact that they actually went out here and did this, I find that so funny. So for those of you curious about the new weapons, the SPR-208 Marksman Rifle / Bolt Action Rifle is available at Tier 15, while the AS Val Assault Rifle is available at Tier 31. So similar to previous battle passes where there were two new weapons, those take the same exact spots, and it won't take you too long to unlock them, especially if you're one of those people that buy those 20 right off the bat. Then you're good to go right away. You'll have the sniper, and you can work your way towards the AS Val. As for the rest of the pass, there are a pretty decent amount of items here that I would consider good and or great, depending on how you look at it. Like, for example, I'm a huge fan of all of the executions, the finishing moves, and the pets that you're able to get. Edward is part of the premium pass, and that's unlocked at 18. Edward's a bat. You can use this bat to execute the enemies that you sneak up on, and not only does he take out the enemy when doing the finishing move, he pulls an Ozzy Osbourne and takes their head clean off. It's actually really cool. Alongside that, there's plenty of operator skins that look really good this season, and each one of them come with their own skin challenges, which allows you to unlock different variants of that skin, just like we've seen in previous seasons. One of my favorite skins this time around is for Domino, and this is coming in at tier 40. This skin has a couple of different color waves to it, and I really do like how it makes Domino look like a completely different operator. At tier 60, you unlock this urban undercover cop look for Thorn, and it kind of of makes him look like 50 Cent. I'm not against that. I think this one looks really cool. And then finally, one of my favorite outfits is at tier 80, and this one is for Reigns. This outfit gives me a couple of different vibes. If it's not reminding me of The Rock from The Fast and the Furious, it's definitely giving me some sweet John Wick vibes. So there's a couple of different colors for this particular suit, and the final one that you can unlock actually has some gold inlay to the shirt itself, which I think is phenomenal. It's such a cool outfit. Now, I never thought I would say this, but there's actually a couple of different customizable watches this time around that I think will complete your ensemble if you're one of those people that like to dress up in this game and do different types of customization like that. At tier 41, you can actually unlock a Damascus watch. So if you wanted to take your watch and maybe match that with whatever rifle you're using or SMG or shotgun that you're using in Damascus, you definitely could do that. Although there isn't really anything special about it other than it just being Damascus, it's still a Damascus watch and I think it's kind of cool. However, at tier 93, there's a way better watch. It's called Strange Magic, and it gives you a projected time up in the air rather than it showing on the face. I'm definitely excited to see what this one looks like in game, though. Now, as for everything else, I mean, emblems and calling cards, and there's some interesting charms there, but I think really where it shines this time around are the skins and, of course, the blueprints that you can get for your weapons. There are a bunch of blueprints this time around that look absolutely phenomenal, not only from the details that are provided on the weapon itself, to the shine and the type of attitude each weapon will bring depending on your playstyle. I've already mentioned that awesome AUG at level 20, that comes with light tracer rounds, by the way, so not only is it going to look like a Destiny weapon, it might actually feel like one as well. At tier 24, you get this Ufaga weapon, which is almost covered in blood splatter. I really like this one a lot. Oh, and I want to mention right away, too, there are no animated weapon skins this time around. I think that people were kind of expecting something like that since we were kind of getting out there with hellhounds and things of that nature. But unfortunately, we still don't have any animated weapon skins or anything of the sort like that. At tier 45, you get a pretty awesome skin called Manzanilla, and if you take a look at it, it's kind of like gold, almost a Louis Vuitton type of deal here, but it's very shiny. I'm excited to see what Damascus looks like on this one. I'm always a big fan of Odin's. I want more Odin variants, man. I love using that weapon, and the fact that we haven't got that many, it kind of makes me sad. Blue Note is available too. This one is kind of interesting, but we've seen weapons with this color wave before. That's at 51. Don't really like that reward over the Odin like we saw before. We actually get a blueprint for the crossbow this time around called Anka, and if you take a look at it, it's got a pretty nice design. It almost reminds me of the Raider design back from Infinite Warfare, but this time around it's got a falcon or some sort of griffin on the side. It's got a nice white and gold scheme to it. I definitely think that's one of the better looking skins, especially for the past. One of those Halloween related skins would be Exoskeleton. This is for the handgun. Taking a look at it, you can see that there is a skull on the side with some roses. But other than that, there's really nothing there. That one, I'm not too fond of. I don't think that it really looks all that good, if I'm being completely honest with you. Then we have Breath of the Gods. This one's unlocked at 76. This one reminds me of some of the variants that we've already had, but it's the different light, like little details that we have. The details are important. It's all in that inlay, all in the accents, the gold. It just looks really, really nice overall. Then a free weapon that you can unlock called Rottweiler. This one is at tier 81. And, you know, I'm guessing that regular camouflage patterns are going to look pretty good on this. I'm not a huge fan of using the undermounted high explosive grenade launcher, the noob tube, but I guess if you change it up, at least you're not going to be losing too much of the detail here. The final few weapons that jump out to me would be Triver. This is the MP7. It's very shiny. It's almost got an orange glow to it. I really, really like this one. And then finally, at tier 100, you get an AS Val variant that looks absolutely brilliant. Always a huge fan of the red on black scheme. And this one provides dark tracers, which we've actually already seen with the small trailer that we got earlier today. So taking a look at this screenshot right here, this small video clip right here, you can see this is what the dark tracers look like. It almost looks like they're zipping through the air. I really like that a lot. You get a couple of different skins for your vehicles through this one as well. The Battle Pass overall, I definitely think, is worth it. Comparing it to Season 5, there are many more items here that I enjoy. I'm actually quite surprised that they were able to pull it off once again. But anyway, that's going to do it for the Battle Pass. I hope you all enjoyed this overview of it. If you did, do me a favor, drop a like on the video. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And once again, if you plan on picking up the Battle Pass, use code PRESTIGE in all caps. It goes directly to supporting me and my family, and I truly appreciate it. Alrighty, folks, I will catch you all on the next video. Peace.